Welcome to the Narrow Path. Thanks for calling.
Yes, hello, Steve.
Hi.
In Genesis 32, verses 24 to 30, it talks about Jacob, who ends up wrestling with a man until the breaking of day. It sounds like Jacob wrestles with this man for quite a while, I mean, until the breaking of day, and to wrestle someone takes a lot of energy. So I was kind of curious about, if that's the case, how could he wrestle for a really long period? And this man is supposed to be God, according to my Bible, yet in verse 26, Jacob prevails against God in this wrestling match. So how could Jacob win against God in a wrestling match? I mean, God could have flicked Jacob off him like a man who flicks a man off his wrist.
Yeah, and the man actually did something to Jacob like that. He touched him on the thigh and immediately crippled him for life.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
You know? So, I mean, it's clear that the man who was wrestling with Jacob, who is later identified as God, he wasn't putting out his full effort. He was resisting Jacob, but probably not trying very hard to pin him, because he could easily do that. I mean, instead of touching him on the leg and paralyzing that, he could have touched him on the back or the neck and paralyzed him for life, you know, and it'd be so easy to defeat him. Jacob was a strong man, no doubt, and energetic in this particular contest. But God was probably, you know, wrestling with him like you might wrest with your child. You don't put your full strength to it, or else it's not a match at all. You let him, you know, do what he can do, and you counter, and you basically resist. But you don't put your full effort because you'd so easily overpower him. I think that's probably what we have going on here. The man was, I believe, what we call a theophany, God appearing in a human-like form. That happens in the Old Testament from time to time. The meaning of the contest is, of course, not explained, but preachers often will point out that God was trying to bring Jacob to the end of himself. Jacob was not yet a complete believer in God. He knew God existed, but he wasn't really willing to submit to him. He wasn't really willing to admit that he needed God. Jacob was a very competent, conniving, strong individual, and trusted in his own strength and his own conniving. And I think this whole contest was to bring Jacob to the point of recognizing that he isn't so strong. In fact, he walked away crippled, limping afterward, and to make him realize that he does need God, that he can't depend on his own strength. I think that's the whole purpose of the contest. In the carrying out of the wrestling match, I've always assumed that God was simply like a grown man wrestling with a child and not wanting to beat them too quickly. God could have exerted all his strength, and Jacob would have been a pile of ashes there. So those are my thoughts about that.